Hi, today I am going to explain you how you can create a parametric model of steel frame in SteelEngineer. My name is Ivan Beleš, I am a support engineer and you can find me at steel.at. We have a new model. I go to project to show it to you. I have selected steel as main material and frame XZ, so we need only 2D frame today. And nothing special in the functionality. What we have to change? We need to activate parametric input. So all other things are default. And now we will draw the structure. So I do it very quick. I create a 3D grid because I want to show you how you can create parameters also for the grid. So the height is 5 meters and the distance of the axis is 6 meters 2 times, so I change the drawing setup a little bit, so put off the grid label and the labels and put this grid to 0 point. Okay, escape, double click with the mouse wheel and you are in zoom all. So now I can close it and draw the structure. So for the structure I need cross sections. There are already some included. I select some standard cross section. We will create also parameters for this cross section later. So, and now I can create members. I use it as a column from this point to this one. F7 to put off the tracking. I don't need it. Escape to finish the input. And again, member as a beam. Okay. From this point to this one, from this to this one. Okay. This is also column. Okay, that's correct. Input of supports. Don't lose the time. And move this node to, for example, 6 meter height. We will calculate this height according of the neglection of the, according of the angle of this beam. So we will input the angle later. So this is the geometry and so not everything. I will create a new member also with the same cross section and I start somewhere. So I need the tracking from this point somewhere here and go 1 meter and also in this point and go 1 meter to the left. So that's the first thing what I have to say about the parametrization. Usually in SteelEngineer you can connect the structure with this button. Then everything will be connected. That's fine if you draw the structure. But then this node is relative node. So I don't want to calculate this relative distance. So I want to input this distance with the height. So what I have to do is to disconnect everything. I go to check structure data because after disconnecting sometimes the free nodes will remain in the structure. And this column I will add, where is it, in modify, polyline edit, insert node. I will add a new node here and I will add also a new node in the middle. You can draw it directly with a polygon and now I move these nodes to this point. Okay. And now I have created this column as a polygon line. And this also. Select only the node to show it to you. So this is a polygon line. I will save my model. On the desktop, Aza.1. That's okay. And now I have a full control over the coordinates. So I can change the coordinates by numbers or later by the parameters. So we need two load cases. One load case for pay I write. This is a permanent load. And second one is the, I write C or crane. It's crane load And this is a variable load in a group. I select something vehicles for the combinations. Okay, that was prepared. Now I can create two loads. For the permanent load, I use line force, for example, with -1, that's okay, in global coordinate system on these two beams. And crane load as a point force. So with -1, that's okay, we will change it with the parameters. Okay, the structure is prepared. I save it again. If you have some structure which is variable, that means you have, for example, wind bracing in one frame or in another frame or in another frame, draw everything in this model and put all these variable beams on separate layers, because we can activate and deactivate the layers, and so we can change the structure. So I do it with this crane beam. So this is the layer one, this is the steel frame. I select a little bit better color, something from here, and a new one is crane beam. And I will put both these beams on the layer of crane. So you can show if you have correct layer by the colors, if you want. So you see the beams with the correct color. Okay, the structure is defined. Now we can go to the parameters. And first we create the parameters you can find in Tools and Parameters. You have to input the parameters in correct order, because if you have some parameter and you need the data from previous parameter, it must be already inputted. You can change the order, you can also create a parameter between existing parameters. So, but you can calculate only with parameters which are above your parameter where you need the formula. The parameters are of different types, for example, for length, what we will do, and we will also use force and line load and also cross-section. So I start with the length, the name of the parameter. The names are case sensitive, so the big L and small L is different. So I write only L, this is the full length, so this is the width of a frame. This is the full width, for example, 12 meters, and the height, so I can select H. That's the height, for example, 5 meter height. I write height on side, not in the middle. The middle we will calculate. For the calculation of this node, we need an angle. Okay, I write A. This is not a length. I need to select an angle. Where is an angle? Angle is here. And I use the value of 10 degree. You see degrees. Why? This is defined in setup units. There are special units for parameters. You can change it. Okay, I go back to parameters. The angle is defined. Now I need this height, and this height is HM for middle. This is not an angle, this is the length. Height in middle. And I use different names for parameters which are calculated and different names for parameters which are inputted. So you see directly which parameter is calculated. This is not a value, we will calculate it by a formula. So we use a simple formula, L divided by 2, times, I don't need brackets, sinus from A. 1.04 meter. We can check it if we input 30 degree for 6 meter, we should become 3 meters. So we can try 30 degree and we have 3 meter. Okay, so I go back to 10 degree. Okay, that's calculated. What we need is the height of this. So we stay at frame. I need also the length, this 6 meter, because in the if I create this or change the line grid, then I need to input this 6 meter. So I need one variable L1. This is the length. I don't use this. And this is formula L divided by 2, 6 meter. Okay. Now what we need is the height. Okay, that's the height. Which I will height for crane. And this is the length and this value. And this value, for example, 4 meter. What you can do, there is a use range. And in this range, you can use value. For example, we start at 0. So it could be also here. It's give not a sense, but it could be. And we can go up to this value. So I use formula and go to H. So we can write here a number between 0 and 5 meter. And the length, what we need. So that's the length of the crane beam. That's the length. It's a value inputted, a value of 1.5 meter. Length of the crane beam, that's the of it's good if you write this description, because later we will create a template for input of these parameters, and if you don't have descriptions, you are lost, so cannot input anything. Okay, I think we have everything what we need for the definition. No, we need also one distance for the line grid, and this is the full. So we need the full height. Okay, that's what I am missing. Height in the middle, for example. Full height. Mm-hmm. And this is calculated by the formula, that's H plus HM. Okay, and it's 6 meter, we don't need limits for the calculation, it's only for the input useful. Okay, I hope that's everything, if not we can go back. And now I have to replace the coordinates by the values of the by the parameter. So I select these nodes and replace 12 meter with the L. Then this is 0, that's okay, the vertical coordinate. So this horizontal coordinate is the L1, that's the middle. This coordinate is the length of the crane beam. This is the length of the crane beam. I'm missing parameter for this right side. Okay, that's the, for example, x1, and that's the length minus L CR. Okay, now I can replace the coordinate with this x1. That's okay. Now the height, so this is the full height, this height in the middle, full. Okay, that's the height which is inputted, that's H. These all nodes have the height of the crane. Okay. And that's everything. All coordinates are defined by parameters. I can look at the table input. At the coordinates, there are some zeros, so you don't need to change the zeros. It's as a value inputted. That's okay. So that was very easy. It was only about the geometry. What we have to do is to change also the parameters to make the possibility to input by parameters also the cross section. So for it, we need first material. I go to the material library, select one steel material, make a copy of them and rename it to steel. This is all our placeholder for material. So, and if we change some material, we select, for example, S235, and this the data of S235 will be put in this steel. So I have to select this selector switch. I hope I do it correct. And now I create a new parameter, new one, steel. Don't need to have, you don't need to have the same name of the material. So, and this is library. This is library, material, value is steel, alternatives. I select from steel these three parameters, close. And now you can select one of this material and the data of this S235 will go to steel. And if you select something else, then the data will go to steel. So steel is your material and the data are used from this one. And now you can, we can also create a cross section. I write CS. This is not library. This is cross section. Where is cross section? Remember nothing. There must be a cross section combination. I cannot read nothing. Length. It says length angle. Library. Relative stress. Man, oh man. CSS rolled. Rolled section. Okay. HAE 300. Okay, and then we can exchange this cross section. You can also input material of type cross section length and use it, for example, for welded sections or parametrical sections. Okay, that's prepared the materials. And I have to select these beams. I select all beams and exchange this one. Ah, no, I have to go in the cross section, edit. And now I exchange this cross section with this CS parameter and material is steel. So if you change it in your template, then the CS will go to this cross section and steel will go here. So, and the last one is the load. So we create two new parameters. I change it to force and this is the crane force. And we are already finished. That's a value of minus, for example, 20 kilonewton and roof load, for example. This is not force. This is line load of minus 6 kilonewton per meter. And I have to add the loads, the parameters to the load. So I select both of them and exchange the value with this parameter 20 and go to the another load case, select both of them and exchange the parameter. Okay, almost finished. What I have forgotten is the line grid. So I go to the line grids. Double click on the line. Don't create a new one because that's a new one. So I want to change it. I go to edit geometry and exchange this with the L1. It's 6 meter two times. And this is the height on the side. Okay. And then we create a new one. This is height of the, no, this is the height in the middle. This is this 1 meter. Okay. Okay. So that's finished. So now we can change the parameters. So I go to parameters. That's not the way how you should do it, but we can try it to, for example, 9 meter. Close, check the parameters and everything is changed. Go back to 12 meter. So, but this is not very comfortable. You can imagine you will have some hundreds of parameters or some thousands maybe. And this is not nice way to change it. Therefore, we have parameter templates. And you can create some tables with parameters. For example, geometry. Oh, not enter. Geometry. And put some parameters. So I start with the material. Then the cross section. Then the length. Height, angle, then the height of the crane beam. So I can create a new group. New group, crane. Okay. Can I move it? Yes. So crane, and then I will input in this group the height and the length. Okay, that's the first one. And the new group for loads. And I will select this crane force and roof. Okay, close. Now you see template dialog, and you can change the geometry simple to 9 meter and close it, and then everything will be changed. I go back to 12 meters, you can change the loads, whatever you want. Mm-hmm. For 1 meter, for example, the length, and then the length will be changed. Mm-hmm. So there is a last thing. If you want to have this dialog a little bit more nice, you can create some pictures, and I have prepared one GIF file. You can use it, and if you have colleagues which should... Oh, what's this? This not the correct group. I go back to parameter settings. Can I deselect it? Simply delete it? No. Excuse me, I go back to the geometry and select my picture for the geometry. Okay. Close. And now if I go to template dialog, then you see the explanation of the things which you will input. So that was very short. There are also more possibilities for the dialogs. You can... Oh, the last one. Huh, I forgot. We have created a crane on a separate layer. So I want to put it on or off. So therefore, I need a parameter for this layer. So we have in the layers, I go back to layer. In the layer, I have two parameters, structural model only and current activity. The both have every time opposite values. So if this is one, then this is zero. So if we activate this activity, then it's visible and it's not structural model only, because if it is structural model only, then it's not calculated. If I put off the visibility, then I want to put on structural model only, so this will be invisible and it will be structural model only, that means not calculated. So I need two Boolean parameters. So I go to parameter, a new one, this is the layer crane visible, for example, and this is one boolean, and it's a value and it's activated. Mm-hmm. And it's a crane on off. Mm-hmm. And then we have a new parameter, a layer crane is a structural model. And it's so, and this is not a value, this is a formula with not layer CV. Okay, and this way it's off. Mm-hmm. And if this is off, then this one is on. Mm-hmm. So you can use it. And now we have to add these two parameters to the layer. So instead of activity directly a value, I select this parameter for crane visibility and this opposite parameter for the structure model. Okay, the activity is activated. I need the template dialog. I put it in the geometry, and this is the layer activity, and I put it in the crane. That's okay. Here, add and move it to the top. Okay, now I go to the template dialog, and I can put this layer off, and then it's invisible and it's structural model only, that means not calculated. So you can do it also with another types of the structure, for example for wind bracing, if you have a continuous beam, then for the fields you can select two or three fields and calculate it. So I hope you have learned something and it was interesting. If yes, click on subscribe button or give me a thumb, and maybe you look on next video. Thank you and bye.